just the legacy that Horton was talking about. But as you said, Horton laying down the law to his teammates, saying that if they weren't successful in everything that they did, the legacy's going to be over. And they got a tall order in front of them being successful in this match.
Well, ironic that Batista and Manu will start this matchup. Manu, the muscle of the Orton Rhodes Manu group. And remember what Orton had said about Batista over the years, back when they were in the group Evolution a number of years ago, that Batista was the muscle of that group, where Orton was the crown jewel.
Well, those are Orton words, of course.
That really started this off. Evolution, a group that turned a number of years ago. Ric Flair and Triple H at the head of it.
Can you imagine Randy Orton thinking in his mind that Batista, Triple H, and Ric Flair were jealous of him?
What I understand, Orton excommunicated from the group after winning the world title because his ego got the best of him. Here is Manu, the son of WWE Hall of Famer, Afa of the Wild Samoans.
Any secret, Orton's ego has its own zip code.
Batista knows all about Manu from a matchup a couple of weeks ago. And here comes the world champion John Cena. John Cena teeing off.
What a talk about muscle. There's the muscle of the legacy being out muscle.
Delayed by Cena and Manu. Powers out, and here comes Cody Rhodes to try his hand with the world champion. Cena and Cody Rhodes had their run-ins over this past summer.
And Orton just took Manu off to the side, gave him a little either instruction or encouragement, or get some words for Manu.
Well, there's no doubt that Randy Orton has established himself as the leader of this group. Many words have been used to describe Rhodes, this young superstar, the son of the Hall of Famer, the legendary American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Brash and arrogant among them, but also athletic. Takedown by Cena.
Come on, Cody! Come on! Show him what you got!
Even when he's standing in the corner, it's just like he's boiled to strike. You ever had the opportunity to just come face to face with a snake, like a big snake, like a boa constrictor or something like that? Just see that there's no emotion in those eyes, and you never know when they're going to strike or what they're thinking. Ooh, that's what I see when I see Orton.
Nice suplex under the leg by Cena yet again. The funny thing about Orton is, and you're right, King, you describe him as not having an emotion, but by not having emotion, he really does have emotion in him. He has full, piercing eyes. And it seems like his mind is working at all times.
Yeah. That's a devious mind, I'm sure.
Machiavellian one.
There's some strength for you. The blood got to be rushing to the head of Cody Rhodes.
There goes suplex, makes a statement for Batista. In this 2-on-3 handicap matchup, Batista and Cena looking for victory. Randy Orton can ill afford to have his team not have a great showing in this match here. So far, Batista and Cena have had their way.
Man, that strength of the solar plexus, Cody Rhodes.
That running bulldog. Cena wastes little time. And Rhodes shimmies at it too. Not sure a bit of emotion there. Concern perhaps.
I'm wondering what Orton is thinking, but thus far I'm not too impressed with the legacy. Is that what he called his group?
Well, he said, make some impact. Do something right tonight, guys, or this legacy is done. It's over.
Maybe Orton's going to have to get in there and show the legacy how it's done himself.
Batista and Cena not allowing Rhodes to catch a break, although that might be the opening Cody needs. Cody Rhodes, a former world tag team champion. Two different occasions.
He Look at this. First time that Batista or Cena has been down, and the first time that Orton has wanted into the match.
Oh, and Batista.
Well, this may want back out, or Orton may want back out in a hurry.
King, in a recent article in WWE Magazine, Shawn Michaels says getting hit by a Batista clothesline is like being in a major car wreck. They're 300 pounds. And Randy Orton, who came in taking his time, that menacing look, and he ran into an emotional Batista. And who could blame Batista after that assault earlier tonight? And there's the quickness of Orton. And this is where Randy Orton is dangerous, ladies and gentlemen.
If he can get his opponent down, he won't give him a chance to breathe.
Never a wasted moment.
Oh. Big boot right in the lower abdomen of Batista.
And he continues the pressure with the King. Doesn't pull the boot right off. Can Orton and company keep it up, or can Batista and Cena get back in it when we return live? We are back live on Monday Night Raw. This is our main event. A 3-on-2 handicap match. Randy Orton, Cody Rhodes, and Manu against Batista and the world champion John Cena. And I'll tell you, Orton, Manu, and Rhodes have dominated Batista since before the commercial break.
We talked about how cold and calculated Randy Orton is. Look at him. He is just opening up on Batista.
Monday Night Raw tonight. Great matches, breaking news, eerie events throughout the entire evening. It all began with this weird situation with Kane and Kelly.
Kane stalking Kelly, and I don't know how that's gonna wind up.
And then Mike Knox attacking Rey Mysterio yet again. Randy Orton laid a trap for Batista, which led to this matchup.
Oh, man.
Manu, cover. Look at Batista in trouble.
He almost took Batista's head off.
Chris Jericho refusing to compete until he gets a match worthy of Superstar of the Year status, but Stephanie McMahon took him to task.
Yeah, sounds like he's gonna get that match next week.
And the new World Tag Team Champions, The Miz and Morrison, retaining the tag team titles.
Man, how does that not snap your ankle?
And for Randy Orton, marching orders were simple for his group. We have to make some sort of impact tonight where this legacy is over. Orton stinging from a defeat to Batista last night at Armageddon.
I said earlier, I hadn't been too impressed with the legacy, but the longer this match goes, the more impressive they get.
Orton, Batista in trouble again and in the wrong corner. And what Orton was just doing there is much psychological as it was physical.
And if you've noticed, yeah, that's what the legacy has been able to do. They are definitely keeping Batista away from his corner and the tag to John Cena. John's just been able to stand over there and watch, help us.
Randy Orton, third generation superstar, the man in the ring, Manu, a second generation star, as is Cody Rhodes. Speaking of that, we even saw earlier tonight another second-generation superstar really making his debut, so to speak. There's a cover by Manu. Yet again, Batista has to power out. That was Sim Snuka.
Sim Snuka, the son of Jimmy Superfly Snuka, here on Raw tonight. And Batista needs to get to John Cena in the worst way. Calculator to count how many times the Legacy has tagged in and out different members. All on Batista. And here's another tag. And once again, Randy Orton. Oh.
Batista trying to get back into this.